In this video, let's start working on the home page. But before we continue, let's come to the final project and take a look at the things contained in our home page. So we have a slider, we have an image here, we have some image in here, we have a map here, and we have some text here. Now let's come back to our project and see how best we can achieve that. So I'll come to my site manager. I'm going to pin this here. If you take a look, you realize we have our index page here, and that is what we use for our master page. What I'm going to do is just make a clone of this particular page, rename this to master page, and I'm going to come back to my index page and get rid of most of the layers I have in here. So I'm going to highlight all, excluding this one. I'm going to delete this one. Let me just get rid of this text, and I think that is that. Let me just pin this and this. I get a full space to work with over here. But on our home page, you realize what we have first is a slider. So let's go to our project and see how best we can bring a slider. So we are going to get a slider from the toolbox that is simply a carousel. So let's search for carousel. I bring a carousel here. Now the size is going to be, let me just make this 740 by 410 pixels. I hit on enter, and I'll let me scroll up a little bit and make sure it is positioned at the left edge of my canvas. And I'm going to double click on this and get rid of two slides here. So I'm going to get rid of the fourth one and the third one. Now I'm going to select the appropriate images I'll be using for my carousel. So let's come here. The first image is a track we have in here. Okay, to be sure, let's just refresh the page and see which one comes first. So I'm refreshing the page to see which image comes first so that we can do the same. Okay, so we have our track image. That is the first image that comes first. So let me just come here. I'll double click on my first slide. I'm going to set a property to image. I'm going to make sure this is set to cover. I'm going to select that is the track. That is a hue track, which was the first image there. Let me just scroll through to see if I can identify that particular track. So this is it over here. I'm going to set this to not repeat, making sure I set up right properties, and I'm going to set this to center. This is going to also be center. Now go ahead and click on OK, and I'm going to do for the second one. So let me change this to image, select the image I'll be using here, this to center, to not repeat, this to center, and this to cover. I'll go ahead and click on OK. And before I click on the final OK, I'm going to switch to properties, and I'm going to change the pause time to that is 7000. And I think I'm going to change the animation to 4 circular. And that is all I'm going to do. Before I click on OK, let me just take away this pagination. I'm going to set this to none, and I'm going to go ahead to click on OK. And let's move this particular layer to hit the edge, that is the bottom edge of our carousel here. And we are supposed to bring in a layer in here. So let's just copy this layer and paste it here. Let me just get rid of this, copy this layer. I'll paste it in here. I'm going to set the size of it to 230 by 41 pixels. So I think I copied. Okay, that's the layer. Let me just do that. And I'm going to move it to fit this particular position. So I'm going to double click on this and select that is the image which is supposed to be used for that part. So I'm going to set this to image, and I'm going to browse through the image I'm supposed to use. So this is the image I'm supposed to use, and let me just get the properties for it right. So this is also do not repeat, this is center, this is cover, this is center as well. I'll go ahead and click on OK. Now let's preview this in our browser and see how it's going to look. So we have our carousel here, we have our image over here. Let's set our master page to this particular page we have in here. So right click on an empty space, go to page properties, under miscellaneous, let's select our appropriate master page. But in a situation we are going to run into some kind of errors, in a sense that we started creating our page directly from the index page, that is from the master page, and we just cloned it. So most of the objects or the items we have in here are going to bear the same name as the object we are going to have in here. To show you that, let me just hit on preview. And as you can see, we have the issues I just spoke about. So when we click on the here, we realize that we have some duplicate IDs in our project. Now to correct that, let's come to our master page and set some sort of naming to our object we have on our master page. So I'm going to begin with this test. I'm just going to change this to header test. This is going to be my logo container. Let me just make this logo container. I think I moved it. Let me undo it. Click on it and change this to logo container. Now I'm going to get the name for this particular layer, which is going to be header. Let me move this back up. Okay. Now this is going to be nav container. That is this one. Let me just paste nav container here. And this is going to be nav. That is what I have in here. It's going to be nav. This is going to be footer. Let me just copy that from here. This is going to be footer. And this is going to be nav footer. So let me just make this nav footer. And this is going to be copyright test. Let me just make copyright. Now let's come back to the index page and preview this again. And as you can see, the banner or the error that was being prompted over there got disappeared. So that is it. Now let's continue building the rest of our pages, still on the home page. Getting to the final page. Now let's come back to our browser and let me just close this and come to the final project. You realize we have some image here. That is two images, this one and this one. And when we go to the services page, it's consistent, it stays there. When we come to the about page, it's there as well. When we come to the fact page, it's there. The feedback page is there. And the gallery page, it is there as well. Same as this contact map we have in here. So what we are going to do is to create a blank page. So let me come to my style manager. I'm going to create a blank page under my master page here. So there's going to be a blank page and I'm going to bring in these images I used in here. So all I need to do is to come to my toolbox, select the layer two. So let me just select layer. I'm going to bring my layer in here. Now let me get the appropriate size of my layer. So the layer is going to be 970 by 148. But before then, let me take away my border. This to zero. I'll go ahead and click on OK now. Let me set the appropriate size for it. I'll go ahead and move this to the top in here. Now I'm going to bring in my image I'll be using for that. So the first one is a clock, which is going to, let me just put that here. And the next one is going to be the big banner with the logos of the various companies. So let me just get that from my images here. So I'm going to bring that in here. That is this particular image. Now I'm going to change the size of this. I'm going to set it to 5. Okay, I think that is 578. Let me just change the position. That is 0 pixels. Let me just move it in here. 0 pixels. And I'm going to change the position of my clock in here as well. So this is going to be, let me just move it into this layer first and set the appropriate position for it. So we have our clock here. We have our banner images, or that's the images containing the logos over here. Now before I continue, making sure the color we are using for the background, that is this particular section, is going to be the right color. So I'm going to get a color for it. Now I'm going to come back here. Let me just double move this out, double click on this layer, come to styles, under this we leave it on solid. We are going to change this to more colors and let's select, that is paste this particular color code in here. So I'm going to move this back here. And let me just preview to make sure it is doing exactly what I want. So that is it. Now we are going to go back to our index page. But before then, let me rename this page to first master object. So this is master object one. Let me just make this one. I'm going to come back to my index page. And this time around, I'm going to look for the master object. So this is going to be master object. Let me just come to my toolbox. I click on master object and I'm going to draw in here. Let me move this layer a little bit to the bottom. I'll move my master object here. Now I'm going to double click on my master object to select this particular the master object I created. It's going to serve as a master object since it's going to run across all the pages in our project. So I'm going to expand this, select this page, click on OK. I make sure I check this one, embed master object as a layer. I'll go ahead and click on OK. And as you can see, we have that in here. So I'm going to do the same process, repeat the same process for the map we have in here. So that if you take a look at this particular session, you realize we have a map in here. So you are going to do that as well. So back to our project, all I need to do is to just, let me just duplicate this page. Let me rename it to master object 2. So I'm going to get rid of this image. I'll get rid of this image as well. And I'm going to change the size of my layer. That is going to be 279 by 405 pixels. So 279 by 405 pixels. I'm going to go to my toolbox and I'm going to go to ready to use JavaScript. So I'll come to my toolbox, ready to use JavaScript. I'll drag it here and I'm going to select Google Map. And I'm going to go ahead and select Google Maps. And as you can see, we have our Google Map options over here. When you take a look at this particular session, we are supposed to paste in our developer key. So I have my private developer key. I'm going to go ahead and paste it in here. And I guess you should get to your private developer keys and paste it in there as well. There's a video or a tutorial on how to get your Google Map developer keys. So this is going to be blurred out. I'm going to get that and I'm going to paste it in here. So I have my developer API key pasted in here. As I said, it's going to be blurred out. And I'm going to change the scroll wheel property from, let me just maintain this to be true. I wanted to make it a static one so that you'll not be able to scroll with your mouse scroll button. But let's just leave this as it is. Let's go ahead and click on OK. And we're going to change the size of Google Map here. So let's just change the size to 262 by 230 pixels. And I'm going to change the position of it to, that is 4 by 256 pixels. So that is going to be the position. I'm going to copy a test I'm going to be using in here. So I'm going to paste this test here. All this is just a test. So an email to the, that is this particular map. That is an email for the page. And when you click on this particular test in here, it's going to give you a larger form or a larger section of this particular map over here. So all I need to do is just come to link and I'm going to link it to the appropriate, that is address in here. So you click on OK and the same thing applies to the email. So click on link and you link it to the appropriate link or email address you're supposed to link it to. Now I'm going to get a size or the position for it. So the position is going to be, let me just move it into this layer. I'm going to change the position to 4 by 26, that is 286 pixels. Now I'm going to get a last test. Let me just copy it and I'm going to paste it in here. So this is a test. Let me just move it to its rightful position. Its position is going to be 4 by 12 pixels. So let me just move it here first and let me just apply the correct position to it. I'll double click on this test and I'm going to set the appropriate style to it. So that is 18 gray bold. That is, let me just change the color from gray to black. I don't think I'll be using any grays, big grays in my project. So let me just make this black. Scroll down and I'm going to change this to black as well. Go ahead and click on OK. Click on OK. Let me just apply it again. Scroll to the bottom. Set this to 18 black. Oh, I should have made this black. Let me just come back here to my style manager and do that. Let me change this to black bold. Let me just make this black bold. Go ahead and click on OK. And let me just apply to this test I have in here. So I'll go ahead and click on OK. Now I'm going to come back to my index page. Let me just move this a little bit to the bottom. And I'm going to pull in my master object here. So I'm going to come back to, or just let me just make a copy of this master object I have in here. I'll paste it here, double click on it, and just change the master object page. So this is going to be the page. Now I'm going to set the position and the size of this layer I have in here. So the size is going to be 970 by 430 pixels. I'm going to move that here. I'm going to move this master object into this particular layer. And I'm going to set the position to 684 by 562 pixels. So it's going to be in here. Now let's go ahead and preview this page and see how it's going to look. So as you can see, we had some issue. Now let's come back and correct that. So it says page one, layer one, master object, two, duplicate ID. So let's just come to the master object two and change the name of test in here. So this is, let's just make this map container. This is going to be map. Okay, so we have that and we have this as well. Now let's come back in to the first one and change the name of this layer in here. So let's just make it banner layer. Now we are done. Let's move this back to its original position. Let's come back to the index page and preview this again. So as you can see, we have everything in its rightful position. So what we are supposed to do next is to get our test, which we'll be using for this particular section. But before then, I'm going to get a color that is the color for this particular layer. So let's come back to our project, double click on this layer, come to styles, change the mode from transparent to solid, and set the appropriate styles to it. I'll click on OK and click on OK, and I make sure I have my styles here. Now let's go ahead and preview this in our browser. So as you can see, we have that in here. So I'm going to copy the test I'll be using and I'm going to paste it in here. So let's come back to our project. I'll paste my test in here, move it here, and make sure I get a rightful position for it. So the position is going to be 15 pixels by 570. And I'm going to double click on this to apply the appropriate style to it. So this is going to be, that is 11 pixels. That is the 11 gray I created. And this is going to be our 16, let's just scroll down. So 16 gray bold, that is the font style we are going to apply to it. So we are done with the desktop view for the home page. Now let's go ahead and preview it in our browser and see how it looks. So as you can see, we have everything which is looking more closely to what we have in here. So everything is here. What we are supposed to do next is to change the title of our page. So we are going to change it to Track Master. So let's come back to the index page, right click on an empty space, go to page properties and change this to Track Masters. So I'll go ahead and click on OK and preview it once more in my browser, making sure everything is okay. So I have that in here and I think I have everything correctly done here. So that is it for the index page. But before I go, I think there should be some form of spacing at the bottom. When we come to the original project, we take a look at the bottom, we have some kind of spacing that should be corrected on our master page. So let's come to our master page and correct that. All I need to do is to just make a copy of a layer or just bring in a new layer. Let me just get a new layer. I'll click on this layer. I'm going to draw on an empty space here, move it to this particular position. Double click on it, take away my borders. So take away the border. I take away the border style. Now I'm going to come to this particular section. That is the background. I'm going to change this to transparent. I'll go ahead and click on OK. Now I'm going to change the height of that particular layer I have brought in there to 30 pixels. The height is going to be 30 pixels. Hit on enter and the width is going to be 970 pixels. Since it's a transparent layer, it's not going to show anything when we preview it in our project. Now let me just go ahead and change the name for that particular layer here. So I'm just going to make this footer space. I'll come back to my index page. Let me just preview this once more. And scroll to the bottom. As you can see, we have our space over there. So that is it for the index page. Let's continue with the rest of the pages.